Hi guys, I've decided to re-record this as I had some audio issues with the stream last night. Just some random static that I didn't really like. But essentially today, we're going to learn how to create a physics-based catapult using the new updates from Soba that were released last week. So this is it in action, and hopefully we get a successful launch. Perfect. Oh, we missed the castle. Let's try again. So let's reset the catapult. Load it up and fire. We're gonna get a hit. I think that's a little bit too far. So let's try moving it down a little bit. Get a bit less power. This is a hit. I can feel it. It's gonna be a hit. That's a hit. Yeah, perfect. So let's learn what's going on. So, we've got some static objects here. They're not doing anything special. It's just we've got this one here. That's just to stop this moving about too much. Underneath, we have just a platform for it to rest on. Up here, we've got a bar that essentially just limits the movement of the platform here, so we get the full momentum. We've got this, which I'll explain in a little bit. But essentially, we've got the lever here. It's a really simple system. All that's really happening here is if we ignore these bits that are just setting up the starting position and resetting it, we've got this event here with a simple weight and an impulse. And this impulse is taking an impulse from a variable. I forgot what we did there. So we've got a variable set up here called impulse, which is a vector variable, and then we're applying an offset. And what shall I start with? So let's just start with what that impulse is doing. So if I delete this a second, just so we can see, oh, that's broke. So let's just delete that. There's a little bug there. We'll have to report that. So what do we want? We want to go to the objects, down to physics, and add impulse. And you see here we get the three values for a vector. We've got an x-axis, we've got a y and a z, and we've got an offset of the same. So essentially, if I just apply a load of impulse on the y-axis, y is up and down. Usually, depends on the rotation, but in this case it's going to be up and down. So when I fire it now, it's just going to go up in the air, up in the air. It's being rotated by this. So if I just move this out the way, because that's a little bit deceiving. Oh, it's sliding off there. Let's just delete that as well. Okay, it's going for a ride. It's going for a ride because of this one. So let's just get rid of this. It can attach to itself for now. Okay, and nope. I'm not having much luck here. There we go. Right. Gone away. So this is going to go straight up in the air, hit that, and fall over. So let's just reverse those changes. I can. And you go back, get there at some point. Oh, lost the platform. Okay. I'm just going to duplicate this. Just a platform to it to rest on. Oh dear. So something to be mindful of when you're undoing is that the changes in the behavior node won't save, or they won't revert, let's say. It's looking good. Let's just press it, see what it does. Perfect. and then resets back to its original location. So it is really that simple. The main sort of functions of this is working. Oh, we need to increase the power, but the main function is working because it's been pivoted by this, and we've got this that stops it. What we can do, if I just move this far away, hopefully it won't go sliding. It's gonna go. I'm going to go for a ride. That's interesting. So let me adjust this, because I didn't spot this before. Maybe that needs to be 7. Okay, that's a bit better. It's not going now. Essentially, it's just going to go up in here. But what we want, actually, is it not to just go up in the air. We want it to pivot as we do it. So how do we do that? We add an offset. And all the offset is doing is changing where that force, in this case the impulse, is applied. So if I set this to 10, what's happening now is instead of the force being applied in the middle, and we're going straight up, force is actually being applied sort of around about here. So we should see this twist. I'm going to leave it. We didn't. Interesting. Maybe that's the wrong location. Okay, yeah, that was a bit too effective, but that's essentially what we want. So if we change that to 5. So obviously what I was doing there was applying the force up here, which doesn't make much sense, but yeah, perfect. It's a bit violent. Still a bit too violent. But that's why we were using this. It just limits the movement. Okay. Interesting. I'm sure how it set that weirdly. That's because I've adjusted where this was. Was that 6 before? Yeah, so that's essentially the catapult. What we also did on a live stream is, since this is a little bit unreliable, and a little bit more unpredictable, is we faked it. So we've got this one over here, which is not using physics up until the point that it generates the cannonball or the projectile. Upside of this is repeatability. We know it's going to work the same way every time. And essentially all that's happening on this one is instead of applying some physics forces, you see we've got physics turned off here. We are applying a orbit, which is a rotation that we can offset slightly, so we're not just rotating the object, we're rotating it around a point. We're creating a cannonball or projectile. We're positioning it, enabling physics on that object, and adding an impulse to it so it flies away. So it looks like it's working. Obviously one thing we could do, we could have a static projectile here and hide it when it gets to the top, add it back when it fires, when it's reset, sorry. One downside of this is, get on, it's not going to affect the player, whereas if we can time this right, we can get launched by that one straight through the floor. Let's just have a look at that. I'm just going to add a small delay. Wanted to increase. What we also discovered on stream, let's see if we can get it to launch just a little bit further, just so I can explain that. 650 to 4. We at least made it there. What you'll notice is, come to the side here. So this is thin, this is thick. So what I think is happening when we're going through the floor is, in the background of the game, there's some predictions on where the player is moving, and probably objects as well. So it's predicting if this is a player, if I'm moving nice and slow, the prediction is quite small. So it's only predicting my next movement sort of like this, which is fine, because when I get to here, it knows the next step is going to put me in the ground. Okay, that can't happen. The prediction's going to put me there. If I'm moving fast, well, in the same time frame, it needs to make a bigger prediction. So instead of that, each frame it might be predicting that I'm there, and then the next frame I might be there, and then the next frame I might be there. And then we'll come to the side for this. Let's move this over. So it might be predicting I'm here, might be predicting I'm here, and then the next prediction I might be here. And that's why we fall through the floor. Obviously, we've got a nice thick layer here. The prediction will go, we're here, we're here, we're here. And then it'll go, well, actually, no, it can't be there, so it must be there. So that's one way of mitigating that, if you're getting that in your games. It's typically going to happen if you're moving fast, if things are moving fast. Yeah, see? Sometimes it doesn't detect. Just need to position a bit better. It's a bit weird. Understand why it works sometimes and doesn't. They'll iron all this out, I'm sure. Just began too fast. And prediction issue again, it's moving past the player before it has a chance to even interact with the player, is my thoughts. So no, we don't want that. It's just that doesn't affect it anymore, so let's go into it. Bring it down 550. Okay. Strange. Yeah. Okay. A little bit strange, but there we go. There is the physics update. Catch you next time.